Many Stanford students have given recitals here, including Walter Hewlett, who's now, you know, one of the big people in the Hewlett Foundation and director of Hewlett Packard. He's the son of the original Hewlett. And so it's been nice to have this this also as now considered one of the Stanford organists. I'm no great shakes as an organist, but as a computer scientist, I'm okay. So this gives me an intro. I can go many places in the world, and people will show me the pipe organs that there are and allow me to play. And I don't have to be that good because I'm just a computer scientist. I'm not supposed to be a musician. So I played on. In Zurich last November, I had an hour to play the fantastic organ at the Fraumünster, the best organ in Zurich. I could play the organ at Wanamaker's department store in Philadelphia, the largest in the world, organs in Netherlands, the famous one at Haarlem, in Kyoto there was a very fine organ with four ranks of pipes that were based on Japanese instruments, quite intriguing. I hardly ever play in public. The only time really was in Waterloo, Canada, where the professor of organ there, and I put on a program of organ duets, some pretty interesting music was written for two players, usually at one organ, but in one case at two organs, and that was the high. I practiced pretty hard before that occasion, and so that was kind of the high point of my organ playing of my life.
How frequently do you play these days at home?
Yeah, I play in spurts. Sometimes I'll go for more than a month without touching it, and then I'll sit down and I'll play for 3 hours or something like that. I shouldn't penalize myself. I usually think, Don, you're behind on this project. You can't afford to take time off and play. So I shouldn't argue that to myself. I should allow myself to do it more. And I enjoy music very, very much. And the pieces that there are. Some pieces written for organ that are so good that you never get tired of them, no matter how often you play them.